So we should, like,
I was thinking that
no,
we should.
No, but I thought.
But yeah. I was.
But
like,
what if?
But
we,
no,
mm.
we
no.
can't. But no. But I think we should.
No.
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 But if you.
But
no,
we should definitely.
Kyle,
yes.
Stop.
Yes, Kyle.
I, no. I think that we definitely
have to think.
Okay.
About,
wait.
Whoa,
whoa,
wait.
Insight.
Oh. Insight. Yes. Insight.
And now it's time for Insight, Boyertown Area Senior High's student-run talk show.
Yo, 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 and welcome to the November episode of Insight.
With Thanksgiving being next week, there's a topic that is always well debated. What is the best Thanksgiving food? Let's hear it.
Stuffing.
It's
potatoes.
Stuffing. It's by far is stuffing.
No.
Because, okay, there's two different types of stuffing.
Yes.
The stuffing that goes in the turkey and the stuffing that's like outside the turkey. The one that's in the turkey is like, it's got some nice warm turkey bits. It's so nice. And the outside is like,
stuffing.
We all know the answer is cranberry sauce.
You're wrong.
That's
or
so
you
wrong.
Wrong.
Stuffing tastes
wrong.
Like couch.
One at a time, please. One at a time, please.
It is obviously mashed potatoes.
Yes.
I agree.
With corn.
Yes.
With corn.
With corn.
No, there's only one thing that stands above all. It's the mashed potato stuffing.
Yep.
When stuffing and mashed potatoes are combined, it's the best
thing. Explain it, Joe. Explain it, Joe.
You basically just put stuffing and mashed potatoes, and it's the best thing
okay.
I've ever tasted.
Okay, so would we consider mac and cheese a Thanksgiving food?
No.
No.
That
yes.
is for the
yes.
week.
It makes me so angry.
No.
That's for the like the 4th of July or like other basic holidays. Thanksgiving is for cranberry sauce and stuffing.
Yes.
Yeah, mac and cheese is a basic lunch food.
Yeah, mac and cheese is for the little kids that
yeah.
show up to Thanksgiving. They're like, I don't like this.
No, baked mac and cheese is an everyday thing. It's not a Thanksgiving thing.
Cornbread. Yeah, you should use it like only as a side if you must. Like, it's not. It shouldn't be the main part of your dish.
Well, it's not the main.
Okay,
yeah,
wait.
But it shouldn't even be
talking
included.
About the main part. Is turkey even good, or
no.
do we just eat it because we have to?
No,
I
turkey.
Like turkey.
Turkey is dry.
I'm gonna,
it's always so.
Somebody
dry.
Is messing up your turkey, and I feel bad for you.
They are. I'm greatly offended.
I've only had one good instance of turkey. It's not really the way that it's cooked. It's kind of like the natural turkey flavor. To me, it tastes dry. It just tastes like deplorable to me.
Also, turkey
I'd
just makes you
chicken.
Sleepy. Why would you want to be sleepy?
Why does
what?
Turkey? No, turkey. No, yeah, that is the thing. Turkey
what?
Has like a thing in it that makes you sleepy. The more you eat,
oh,
no,
it's called tryptophan.
Yeah,
it's a, wait, I'm not even kidding. It's like a chemical or something. I don't know what it's called. It's called tryptophan, and it makes you sleepy.
Yeah.
You just haven't had a wet, moist turkey before. Stop talking.
No.
Cornbread.
Yeah, cornbread.
All day. I'm switching it up. Cornbread.
Dude, cornbread's the best. Like cornbread and cranberry
cornbread,
sauce are the two
cornbread.
Best.
Cornbread.
Yeah,
cornbread.
Cornbread is like dry.
No.
Yeah,
Wawa's cornbread.
Wawa's cornbread is pretty good.
I don't like Wawa's cornbread.
Okay, Wawa has
leaf.
Like,
that's.
I tried it the other day and I was like super excited to eat it, but I didn't like it.
Wawa's cornbread is now better than Boston Market's cornbread.
I do not like Wawa's cornbread.
I said what I said. I said
Boston Market is the most underrated fast food.
No one goes there, ever.
It's overpriced hospital food.
I go there.
Would you? Do you guys like the gobbler at Wawa? If you know me, you know I'm a big fan, and I always get half stuffing, half sweet mashed potatoes. And I get turkey on top because I like the gravy, not because I like turkey. And then also they came out with cornbread this year, which is bussin'.
She eats this about 5 times a week. I'm not even kidding.
It's good. I don't blame her.
All right, I've got an unpopular opinion. I don't like gravy that much. Gravy's just kind of...
Get out.
I can't stand gravy.
Get
I don't
out.
Know what it is. It's just not good.
It
like
makes your turkey moist.
It makes... That's uncomfortable, that's though. Like, why would you
turkey.
Want...
You
I mean,
want dry turkey?
You don't want dry turkey, but you don't want it to be, like, dripping with something.
What is gravy?
No wonder you guys don't like turkey.
Gravy is fat.
Is it just
it's
fat?
Just fat.
That's
why
so
yummy.
Like
turkey.
Because we're American.
It's brown and gross and smells bad.
I can't.
Okay, I think we've had enough of food. Let's talk about what we're doing for Thanksgiving this year. Do your families do any different Thanksgiving traditions, or do you have any plans with your family this Thanksgiving?
Well, for this year, I'm going back to like New York for a while to visit my family back there. And we just basically just have a fun time because there's a lot of little kids. I just play with them. I plan on like spending time with my family since I haven't seen them in years, and for the kids, I'll wear like a chicken suit or whatever. But,
oh.
But yeah.
Turkey suit.
No, I don't have a turkey soup. I'll go with what I can get. The kids won't tell the difference.
Franksgiving. I'm going to try that out this year, probably, maybe.
What does that mean?
It's a play on words, because it's my last name. So I think that would be like a funny, like, new tradition. It's Thanksgiving, but Frank edition.
Yeah.
I will be attending.
Is that what your family calls it? They call it, oh, let's come over to the Frank house for the Franksgiving.
Yes. Franksgiving is when I celebrate how grateful I am for Elizabeth Frank.
Thank you.
And I do it every year, even before this year when I met her. I just knew one day that I would appreciate her.
I do the classic American thing. We all have Thanksgiving. Everybody does. But then we watch football.
Oh.
And then it gets better. All the dads, uncles, granddads all hunker down on the couches and are out.
Yeah. In the past, before COVID, my family from out the country would come and visit us. And what we would do is I'll just sit on the couch and scream at the TV while football's playing. It's a great time.
I'm glad we don't have like any little cousins or anything, because I hate kids.
Can we take a moment to appreciate the Macy's Day Parade?
No.
That is the highlight of my...
Guys,
it's amazing.
Watch me on the Philadelphia Thanksgiving Day Parade. Really? I'll be dancing in it, which is pretty awesome. So,
Yeah.
You know, so I always have the parade like up on my TV. I never watch it. It's always just been there in the background.
I put it on like when my parents are cooking. Yeah. They'll like play it in the background. Yeah, like, but like nobody in my house actually watches the parade.
My dad and my grandma will be fighting, and then it'll just be on the background.
It's background music when you're stretching for all the food.
Yes, I agree with you, Joe.
Okay, but when else can you see like a giant Garfield just floating in the air? Yeah. Like
my dreams.
My favorite Thanksgiving tradition, because I don't really care about Thanksgiving that much. Like, I obviously like giving thanks and all that. Yeah, that's important. But like the food is just not my favorite food. What I look forward to is begging my mom afterwards to leave whatever party we're at and then go Black Friday shopping the night before.
I've never been Black Friday shopping.
You have to.
Neither have I.
I've never.
It's so, you can come with me and my mom.
Okay.
So this year is the first year that I work retail on Black Friday.
Good.
And I work 5:30 a.m. to 2 p.m. I'm actually excited.
Who's going to Mountain Warehouse though?
Hey. We can get some great deals at Mountain Warehouse.
Do you guys got real snowboards, or is it just like jackets and stuff?
We don't sell snowboards. We sell jackets.
Do you sell mountains?
I think we've all seen that one South Park episode though before with Black Friday.
No.
Like
no.
I don't know who he is.
Personally, I have only gone shopping once during Black Friday after Thanksgiving, and it was like the last time. The lines were like out the door.
Yeah, I can't.
And
do that.
It was terrifying because people were like acting. I saw mobs.
Yeah, I don't have the patience for lines or anything, so I will not be attending.
I've only been in a store once on Black Friday, and it's because we need a can opener of all things, and it was at like 7 at night. And we just walked in the store and we walked right out because everything was like all over the place, and it was like everything was like gone.
Well, although we are only 3 weeks into November and haven't hit Thanksgiving yet, Mariah Carey's hit Christmas song, All I Want for Christmas Is You, is back in the top 10. Is it too early to start playing Christmas music?
No.
Is it also too early to start decorating for Christmas?
Yes.
No. My parents have already put up, well, it's not our real Christmas tree, but we already have a Christmas tree.
Well, your parents were wrong.
No.
No, my parents are right.
You can't do anything Christmas related until Black Friday. Black Friday is a designated day for Christmas celebrations to start.
I agree.
Okay,
then why did you hang up Christmas lights already?
What would you do up from like Halloween to Thanksgiving if you're not gonna be doing Christmas stuff?
Normal things? What do you do in like April to September?
I listen to Christmas music.
I don't know.
And then as soon as it's October, it's Halloween.
Christmas starts after Thanksgiving.
No.
That is when it starts.
No. It's, it's the you can put up Christmas decorations and defrost Mariah Carey on December 1st. Will and you? That is the rule.
No.
That is too late.
I have a
once Halloween is over, the Christmas songs begin. The Christmas
one at a time, please.
There's no Thanksgiving music. I don't care. Okay.
Yeah. And first also off, in Christmas songs, they say like pumpkin pie and stuff. What do you eat on Thanksgiving?
Pumpkin pie.
You can also eat that on Christmas.
Do you celebrate the 4th of July in June? No.
I don't celebrate the 4th of July. I don't really celebrate the 4th of July.
She got you there.
You don't.
Like, oh my God.
Halloween in September? No, you don't! You don't!
Christmas is the most important time of the year!
There's like a
Santa, Jesus!
Okay. Don't get me wrong. I love Christmas, but it should be condensed to 1 month. That's enough. That is enough.
No, it's not.
It's Christmas season.
I think that Halloween should be extended another month.
No, I don't think it should.
Nah. Well, think about it.
Charlotte, like, you're the type of person to start celebrating your birthday a week early.
I start celebrating my birthday a month early.
That's why you should.
That's why I celebrate Christmas.
Charlotte for a whole month.
Well, like, there's a lot of different Christmas songs, and imagine working in retail and all you hear is the same voice every day, like hours at a time. That's gotta drive someone insane. Like, all I want for Christmas.
Such a good song, though.
Christmas at all before Thanksgiving, you are not allowed to celebrate Thanksgiving. That is my rule.
You sit and you wait out until Christmas.
True.
I just want to say I listened to Christmas music this morning on the way to school. So.
Oh my God! Yes.
Am I dance
it was
studio?
A mix between Christmas music and Red for me.
At my dance studio, we have to practice like when we have a Christmas show. Those years that we. The wires on Jackson. When we have to do our Christmas show, we practice all throughout the summer. Like, we start learning our dances and dancing to Christmas music in summer. Yeah. So I'm kind of desensitized at that point. Christmas music doesn't mean anything regarding the season to me anymore.
I remember doing that at Julie Kell's Dance
Center. Yes, Julie Kell's Dance Center. Me and Gab. Loved that. Yes, I mean, I loved it too, but after a few years, it.
But that just ruins Christmas music for you.
What dances were you in, Gabby?
Okay. Okay.
Christmas time is a special time. If it's like all year round and like not during Christmas time, it wears off.
It doesn't
the
feel
magic
like
of
Christmas.
Christmas wears off.
I don't think
it gets boring. It gets too much.
I believe that as soon as you shove that last bite of pumpkin pie in your mouth, then it's Christmas.
Yes. Yes.
Boom.
All right. So moving on to something different, the Astroworld Music Festival in Houston, Texas, took place Friday, November 5th. Was supposed to continue on to the 6th. After many issues with security at the event and unruly concertgoers, 10 fatalities were reported, along with hundreds of people injured, as guests reportedly rushed towards the stage. What are your thoughts on Astroworld? Is Travis Scott responsible for what happened at this event?
I don't think people should have to fear for their lives at a music festival. Yeah, like, you're going to have fun. You're going somewhere. Like, people look forward to that. And you should not have to fear for your lives. I don't think Travis was entirely responsible for it. He had a contract that made him not be able to prevent the show. But I do think he should have done something, or at least acknowledged what was happening.
Well, I feel like it's a problem, an issue with overcrowding, since like you shouldn't be able, concerts are meant to be big, but especially during a pandemic, you need to cut back on the size. You have to have some sort of cap. And like the way he isn't responsible for like the fatalities, like they showed up. It's unfortunate, but he didn't directly cause it. But the way he dealt with it, the way he apologized just makes him seem like nonchalant about the entire situation.
I think that inciting a riot, though, kind of makes you responsible for people dying.
I think that people are mixing up what it is. It wasn't a concert, it was a festival. Yeah. And if you've ever been to a concert, you know, you stay in your seat, you like cheer, you sing along to the songs. A festival, it's just a mosh pit, really.
Yeah.
So you haven't been to a festival to experience it, then you don't really understand what it's like.
Joe has only been to a Taylor Swift and a Beyonce concert.
Was it good?
Joe,
Beyonce
same.
Was fire, I'm not gonna lie.
I've only been to a Taylor Swift and Katy Perry concert.
I've only been to One Direction and 5 Seconds of Summer. That was the best night of my life.
I was there. August 13th of whatever grade.
We were there. there was also another conspiracy about the event, that it was a possible satanic ritual. Anyone have any thoughts on that?
I do. I have multiple thoughts.
Let's hear it.
First off, no. Like, what? Where would it happen? Again, unfortunately, there were 10 confirmed fatalities. But why? What type of context? Where do you get that conspiracy where a festival of like music would be a satanic ritual? Like, imagine dying and hearing "That's lit," and like, and it turns out to be a satanic ritual. Like, it's just music, albeit auto-tuned. It's just music.
You know, well, in my personal opinion, I think one of the best ways to go out is by Travis Scott saying "It's lit" and me never hearing anything again. I think that might actually, yeah.
Okay.
That might be good.
Anyone have anything respectful to say?
For the conspiracy thing, I think people just wanted something to blame. And for the people that don't blame Travis, they need something to blame. And that's just their way of, oh, this is what that was because God wouldn't let that happen, right? That's what people would think. Yeah,
I agree with you.
Yeah, you can't like find a scapegoat in something completely just unrelated to the topic. People died. It's, and Travis Scott like holding that festival where definitely a lot of people would show up. I don't think it's totally his fault, but there should be definitely some blame there. So like blaming a satanic ritual on that doesn't just doesn't seem like a valid reason.
It's also hard for him to see in a crowd of like 50,000 people when 10 people like pass out.
No, well, but it was like hundreds of people. Like, you could see it. If you see videos, there were like circles of people dropping to the
floor.
That
happens a lot at
I know, but like, you would at least acknowledge, be like, yo, security, get over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, also, there was,
he wasn't even acknowledging there's a video that was happening
there
until
was,
he was like, oh, there's a guy in a tree back there. Like, okay.
There was people climbing on the ambulance that was trying to get people out. Like, people like were standing on top of it, like preventing it from getting out.
And there's videos of like people trying to climb up on stage saying like, people are dying, like we need help.
And,
like,
yeah, they were chanting to stop the show.
Yeah, they were chanting to stop the show.
I think Travis is at fault. Yeah. I mean, the company that held the event is more at fault, but
yeah,
Travis could have stopped
it. I saw a video of like people like rushing through like security and like not even like being checked.
I think the scariest video was the video of the one person literally being like unconscious, crowd surfed, and Travis Scott's just like staring at them singing. Have you seen that? It's a whole
he's doing,
robot.
Who's doing the robot?
I watched the video. Yeah. They're too graphic.
Like, how could you ignore that? People must have been like dropping like flies for that to happen. And how could you not stop the show like completely and say, hey, people are passing out. Let's bag it, like, let's quit. Because, like, you'd have to feel some sort of empathy, some sort of compassion as a human being. So I feel like Travis is mostly at fault for that.
What?
We have the wrong mics.
Oh, okay.
There's I just wanted to mention, there was a video that Kylie Jenner posted, like, oh, AstroWorld Festival is so fun, like, just a video of the concert, and you could see the ambulance, like, the paramedics in, like, far in the distance. Like, I know that can happen at concerts, people pass out, especially at things like that, like, music festivals, but how tone deaf do you have to be to, like, see the ambulance and be like...
Yeah, I also saw his apology video, and I thought that was ridiculous.
God, it's pathetic.
He looked pathetic. He was, like, going like this. I think he just looked ridiculous. That's embarrassing.
Yeah.
He didn't even actually say sorry.
He never actually said sorry.
Both Kylie Jenner and Travis Scott, like, addressed the situation, but Travis Scott just sort of seemed like... Dang, I didn't know that would happen, bro. Like, I didn't know people would die. Like, I mean, that's not good. That's not lit.
Exactly. Like, he was just like, damn, that's not lit.
It ain't so lit after all. It ain't so lit after all. Like, my bad. Like, I don't know. Peace.
Okay.
My bad. My bad, G.
Anyway, Governor Wolf has stated that starting January 17th, he will phase out the mask mandate for schools as it's time to prepare for a transition back to a more normal setting. Without a state mask mandate, it will be up to the school districts to decide whether or not to require masks. Do you think Bash will keep masks in school or follow the state ruling? What would you rather, mask or no mask?
All right, I'm gonna be real with you. The reason they picked January 100% is because of Christmas and Thanksgiving.
Yeah, they wanted to see what would happen.
Everybody gets together. COVID spreads.
Sorry, we can't.
and leaving it up to the schools, I don't think the schools are going to do much anyways. And they're just going to keep it the way it is. Mainly because, like, yeah, if it leaves, cases are going to rise. But, like, even the slightest case rises, they're bringing it right back. They're bringing it right back.
I don't think.
New school board election.
Yeah, you have to talk into a mic.
I don't know though, because like the school board is different now. Different people are going to be making the decisions. I feel like Boyertown, I feel like parents here are not everyone's parents, but a lot of parents are probably going to be on Facebook rallying to like unmask our kids. Yeah. And like, I feel like they're going to give in to that. And I mean, I'll keep mine on. I don't know. I don't feel comfortable in that high school with all these, like, I don't know. I feel like this is where COVID would thrive.
I feel it has.
There's people out in, like, there's whole periods out of school because they all got COVID. Like,
yeah, I feel like we should keep the masks, especially right after, like, holiday season. It's just going to be way too unsafe, in my opinion, because, like, we're going to have, no matter how many people are vaccinated against this disease, surges will always happen for a while. And especially after everyone's finished gathering. So I feel like we should do a gradual transition, like, but instead of just like the dramatic, like masks being mandated to like no masks at all or like masks optional, I feel like it should be like a steady decline.
Boyertown never really had the green light to actually unmandate the masks because literally yesterday we had 15 cases in the district. And just because of that, I don't think that anything is like improving for them to say, oh, well, we don't have to have the mask mandate. Like nothing really happened to give them that approval and to permit like the unmasking.
Masks.
I also feel like,
go ahead.
I also feel like unmask everyone because then if someone does get COVID, there's going to be like so many more close contacts and that's just going to end up like more people being out, and I feel like that just causes more problems, like, overall.
I also feel like the whole thing is just going to create more problems. Like, if we're leaving another opportunity for no mask, people are just going to think that's going to happen, then they're going to get mad, then it's going to be a whole thing over again, and then we're going to have to, I don't know, it's just, like, a whole thing.
I feel like we should allow masks, like, after, like, a few weeks at best. We should, like, allow masks, people to wear masks to their own volition and have them realize that maybe, like, if they get COVID, it would be because of their actions. Like, not saying that it's right or wrong, but like people need to be held accountable if we do allow people to, like, not wear masks.
I feel like the people that, like, complain the most about having to wear a mask, like, don't even wear it. Like, it's literally just on their chin. So, like, they kind of just do whatever they want anyway, so.
Yeah, everyone's going to go out Christmas break, Thanksgiving, whatever it is, going to go out. They could get COVID, right? Then they're going to come back to school, spread it. Cases are going to rise. Everyone's going to take off the mask mandate. Cases are going to rise. Within like 2 weeks, they're going to have the mask mandate back on again. It's just going to be a pointless thing.
I don't know. I think once they take the mask mandate off, we're not going to have it back because, like she said, our school board's 8-1 Republican.
Oh, jeez.
And most of them want it off.
Yeah. I also feel like we definitely shouldn't have it taken away because we want a prom. Like, our senior trip was already canceled. If COVID has the opportunity to surge again right before something like prom or even like a few months before, we're not going to be able to get that. And also, I'm in a position where like I am so serious about COVID because my mom's in chemo right now. So she has like no immune system. And yeah, I
people who don't take it seriously because, like, oh, it only affects people with underlying conditions. Like, you don't know who that is. Like, it's people's parents, people's siblings, people's grandparents.
I feel like you got... Some people have to have a heart, and even though your family could be entirely healthy, some people aren't. Some people didn't have the chance to be born without any underlying conditions or, like, contract any underlying conditions. So I feel like a longer mask mandate would be beneficial to everyone, but at the same time, it all depends on what the school board thinks. And even if the decision is to not wear masks, if cases rise, we'll probably be back to virtual school.
I agree with that. Now we're going to take another turn. We would like to take this opportunity to congratulate the girls volleyball team and the boys soccer team for an outstanding season. The boys soccer team had a final record of 15-8, and the girls volleyball team had a final record of 18-6, and were Pac-10 champions. Wow, I cannot talk. Did any of you get out to any of the games?
I got out to a lot of games, and... I don't know, this is fresh on my mind.
Oh.
The PAC needs to hire new referees for all their sports because I went to multiple games and it was just unbearable to watch because, like, for example, Beckett Wagner tackled.
Wanger.
No penalty. We ended up losing the game because of that, and I wanted to throw something at the ref.
Thank you, Joe.
Even football. Football, especially Joe can testify for that. Best manager in the pack right here. Ladies and gentlemen, clap it off, clap it off. There you go. Yeah.
Anyone else?
Anyone on this side?
Anyone go to the games? Anyone?
Yeah, volleyball.
I did not.
Okay. Thank you, Kyle.
Okay, moving on. 25-year-old black man Ahmaud Arbery was out for a jog in a predominantly white neighborhood February 23rd of last year. He was shot and killed by three white men who claimed they saw him commit a crime. The trial for his murder began on November 5th, 18 months since his death. Do you think it was justified for these three men to take matters into their own hands? Should they have waited until law enforcement arrived? Do you think they will be found guilty of murder or a lesser crime such as aggravated assault?
They had no right to do what they did, and they should get charged for anything they're being charged for, because if you watch the videos, they just drove up to him and basically shot him. He didn't even have any time to react to them. He barely knew they were there. What happened was like an execution. They didn't even try to talk to him. He was just jogging.
They had no right to do anything whatsoever. They should have, if they thought that he was being suspicious or whatever, they should have called law enforcement and made a report there. They did not have the right to put their hands on him, and they murdered the guy, and that... They didn't have the right to even touch him in the first place. So, no, they didn't have the right to do that. That's all.
Yeah, and, like, you can claim whatever you want, like, whether it's true or not. Like, be like, oh, he looks suspicious. How, like, it's, like, shooting and killing someone is still murder.
Yeah, even if you think someone looks suspicious, it gives you zero right to end their life. Mm-hmm.
And let's just take race out of it for a while, even though it's very predominant. And, like, as a minority, it doesn't really matter if you are racially motivated to do something or not. You don't have the right to shoot someone on sight unless they are about to kill you.
It's not self-defense. Yeah, it's not threatening your life.
Yeah. You can have your opinion, but leave justice in the matters of people who are able to bring justice to you. You shouldn't take it into your own hands. I believe that they should be charged for murder. He did not resist. He didn't even have a chance to put up a fight. He was not suspicious at all. And even if he were to be suspicious, you should call the police. You shouldn't take matters into your own hands and resolve everything with extreme violence. If you were to detain him, maybe I would get that. But immediately shooting and killing him in such a brutal, like, execution style way, I believe that they should get the full penalty.
I've seen something, I think it was probably a TikTok, that pointed out the fact that, like, a lot of the time cops are allowed to shoot and kill someone and claim self-defense, and then if a woman was to, like, kill her rapist, she would go to jail for life. Mm-hmm. And this guy was just jogging on the side of the street. He didn't even do anything that was remotely close to that kind of thing. And it does disproportionately affect Black people, and it sucks, and it's so sad. And I don't know, I feel like the justice system just is not working. Like, not working at all.
It doesn't matter how suspicious someone looks. Like, just because they look different doesn't mean they should be automatically suspicious. It doesn't matter if they look like they're homeless. It doesn't matter if they look rich. People, it's not like the look. It should be about their character and their demeanor. If you had reason to think that someone's suspicious, a rational mind would say, hey, y'all, let me check. Let's see if they're really suspicious, I'll call the cops. But you shouldn't just immediately say, hey, look, someone looks different from me. Okay, they're evil. I should shoot them. That's all. Like, that doesn't really make sense to me.
I think we can all agree. He was executed, hands down. He was executed. He didn't resist. He didn't do anything. To be honest, I don't even think he was being suspicious. I think this is all 100% racially motivated, in my opinion.
Yeah. All right, another case being tried now is that of Kyle Rittenhouse. On August 25th of last year, Kyle Rittenhouse went to a police brutality protest in Kenosha, Wisconsin, with an assault rifle and shot and killed two protesters while injuring another. He testified in his trial that began on November 1st that he was attending the protest to render first aid and help extinguish fires created by rioters instead in an act while he claims is self-defense, becoming a murderer. Is it fair for people to act as law enforcement and take matters into their own hands? How should he be charged, as a murderer or for acting in self-defense?
I'd like to say one thing. I watched pretty much most of the whole like court thing, like live. He tried to earn some pity points, and I give him a solid zero.
That judge is not, I don't think he should be judge of the trial. He has like the Trump theme song as his ringtone, and he's like taking calls during the thing and whatnot. That guy's a mess. Rittenhouse, I think he should be charged as a murderer. He clearly tried to get pity points. I don't know if he fully thought through what he was doing when he did it. I think he did, because he drove across state lines to do what he did. But he's 18. I don't think he should be given a life sentence. I don't agree with what he did whatsoever, but he's 18. I think he should get like, what, 30 years? I don't know what the murder penalty is, but he has a life, and I think that he deserves a fair shake after he's done in jail, and he should definitely go to jail.
If you watch the prosecution at all, they did a horrible job. And I think personally the defense will end up winning this, not because of the sole fact, like, throughout that he's guilty or not, the prosecution put no evidence forward of why he should be charged. And the defense just was like, oh, the one guy he shot had a gun and the other guy ran at him and hit him with the skateboard. Like, that, unless you provide more evidence, is enough for someone to get off with self-defense. So in my opinion, the prosecution didn't give enough for him to be charged.
Going back to the judge, I think it was made that they couldn't call the victims victims. Instead, they could be called rioters instead, to make them sound more violent and like they incited this, like it was their fault. Like, they literally were not allowed to be referred to as victims, even though they got shot, which I just think is ridiculous and probably, I don't know, I think it's very morally wrong to like tell someone what they can and can't say on a trial. I don't know. I mean, I don't know the rules about that, but like saying they're not victims when they literally got shot point blank is not right to me.
I think like also during it, there were like different like Black pastors like coming into the trial to like see the trial and everything. And like, I guess it was like one of the lawyers, and he was like, he literally like said something like, how many like Black pastors are gonna like come in like to the trial? And I think that's definitely like very disrespectful and unfair, because it's like, there's this big issue going on. If people can come in and see and like support, and just for you to like say that is very alarming.
Like, I don't know how you'd extinguish a fire with a rifle. Maybe like shoot at it and pray it goes away. Like, don't go, go away. It's kind of like singing the rain, go away, to like make the sun come out or whatever. And I think he should be charged with murder. If he doesn't get a life sentence, which is pretty unlikely based on the prosecutor's performance, he should get a life-changing sentence, because even if he doesn't go to jail, he'll always be remembered as the guy who shot someone, who shot two people and killed
them. At 17 years old.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And
17 years old.
And the fact that he was like trying to throw a pity party. If you're going to commit a crime, if you're going to buy a gun, if you're going to like shoot someone, you might as well own up to it. Don't act like a little baby. And it's like, what? Like, no, you just killed someone. You killed two people.
I agree.
Unfortunately, I don't think they'll be able to do anything because the prosecution did such a bad job that they weren't able to prove anything. And if anything, it's going to come down to not only the judge, but I don't know, like, where they got the prosecution from, because if you watch the trial, it was sad, like, how bad of a job. It was like they were almost on his side.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We're going to move on to the next topic now. After the disappointing news that homecoming was canceled, it has just been revealed that there are a few upcoming dances this school year. On December 17th, there is a snowball dance, followed by a military ball, a junior prom, and the prom. Are you excited for these upcoming events? Do you think COVID will interfere with these dances? And do you guys plan on going if they don't get canceled?
I'm going to be honest. I'm not going to the snowball just because, like, I think it's annoying that our homecoming did get canceled when, like, every other school in our area, like, had one and that, like, was fine, I guess. Like, they had to wear masks. Like, it was outside. Like, their school districts, like, found a way. I guess, I don't know, that's like, snowball just doesn't really seem...
I'm not going to be going because it's Spider-Man
Day. Spider-Man Day.
Oh, forgot Spider-Man about December. That.
Get your hands off me. new trailer tonight, 8 p.m., I'm pretty stoked.
December 17th is the day that the new Spider-Man movie comes out, which is terrible planning by them.
Snowball, then Spider-Man, because you go to the Spider-Man film in all formal gear.
But I want to see it multiple times that day.
But you could see it the first time it premieres in formal clothing and still go to snowball.
I might not go to school. Yeah, so I could see Spider-Man multiple times.
I think Jackson and I...
As Spider-Man.
Jackson.
The prom.
Are we gonna skip school that day to go see Spider-Man?
I think we should.
And then we'll see it in the morning. And then we'll go see it at night.
Can I join?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Awesome.
Spider-Man viewing party right here.
But also, I'm upset because you can't bring guests to this dance.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't be able to bring my girlfriend. So it's just, exactly. What? Shut up. You know what I mean?
Oh, like, no, I can't.
I can't bring my girlfriend.
I hate you all right here. This
my
is a problem.
My girlfriend can't come to the dance. No.
Boyfriend, though.
Also, I feel like.
I can bring Jackson.
Yeah, Jackson.
I feel like them canceling homecoming was such a big thing. And, like, I feel like that wasn't that long ago. And, like, now they're like, oh, we're having a dance next month.
And, like,
you know,
five more.
It, like, kind of, like. I don't know. It's like
yeah,
stupid.
True. Especially after Thanksgiving.
Yeah. Also, I think it's weird because like homecoming, we could have had outside, but in the winter, like last year, the cases rose a lot more,
mm-hmm.
and then it's gonna be inside. So it's like, how did that even make any sense at all? But
if they cancel prom, I'm going to riot.
I agree. Oh my God, yeah. I agree.
They're saying that it's happening, but you know, knowing.
Boyertown.
Yeah, knowing our school, that's...
They did cancel our class trip literally months
exactly.
in advance, and it's just...
Also, I know that this isn't the topic, but you had to apply to get the money back for the class trip. God. They still haven't given that back. It's $1,000. They haven't given that back to the parents either, which is kind of ridiculous.
As a class officer, I'm sorry about that.
Yeah, and you had to apply to get your money back, which is like a 15-day period. Which
and they
like,
said if you didn't apply to get your money back, then you aren't getting your
exactly.
money back.
Exactly. It's
I was
ridiculous.
Like, oh, okay.
Yeah, it's already spent, Jackson. I'm sorry. That money
yeah,
is long gone. Long gone.
I'm spending that on a Build-A-Bear for the showcase outside the lunchroom.
Thank you, Joe.
You're welcome.
Worth it. Worth it.
Yeah.
Okay. So there's been a recent Instagram page called Bash Bad Parking featuring students messing up their parking jobs in the school parking lot.
Like Celia.
Are you a fan of this account? And do you
no.
think any of your friends other than Celia are going to be on the page?
I think
I'm
Riley
Van
Gerson should be on it.
Yeah. I have the most liked post right now.
and the
yeah. Yeah. job on the page so
it's
far.
It's not even, it's
like
not even funny
ago.
How bad it is.
The one red car.
The red Ford.
I was looking at that scene. I was like, how stupid does a person have to be parked that
this
bad?
Stupid.
Like, Celia, how, talking how about, can you be that
one
bad?
One at a time, please.
I have a theory. My sister is the one that made that page
what?
For the sole reason what? That every time we come what? In the parking lot in the morning, she's like, oh, I can't believe how people park that bad
that's,
every
Joe,
single
that's
morning.
That's not my page.
It probably is your page.
It's not.
I have a theory it's your page.
It's not.
Your theory's wrong, Joe.
See how she's going to get defensive now? She's
I think
defensive.
The page is such a good idea. I know who not to get in the car with. But also, there's other pages about feet and
bad,
bad
posture.
Postures.
Yeah, bad posture. Too.
Oh, no.
You're going to be on the bad
well,
posture
I,
one, too.
Well, well, I've seen my fair share of Boyertown things, and I plan on following that bad parking page very, very soon, actually after school. I've seen multiple things like Boyertown shipping, even though there's like two posts on it. There are so many different ones, and I don't know how I found them, but I am both glad and disappointed in our school.
Well, I think the Boyertown okay. feet is weird and creepy, and you should stop it. The bad parking, however,
didn't
is very funny.
You? Didn't the foot
yeah,
page
yeah.
follow
they
you?
They followed me. Yeah. I don't know why they followed me. Like,
yeah, no, the posture one followed me, and
here
I was like,
go.
Are they trying to tell me something yeah. here?
Well,
I know, I was really, I sit like this. No, and I was sitting in lunch, and I was like, they could be in here. So I kept like checking myself.
Going along with weird and creepy Instagrams, In the Hall is a popular segment that has run on Bash TV for 20 years. This year, Jared Drabik is the host. Recently on Instagram, an account named Jared in the Hall underscore fan account has popped up, posting many photos of Jared, either from his show or sent in by students in the school. What are your thoughts on Jared having a fan page? Is it creepy or funny?
It's amazing.
Without mentioning names, do you think this account was started by a friend or some random freshman fangirl or who?
I'm not going to lie. I keep sending in pictures to the account. I'm not going to lie. I'm not the owner of it. I wish I was. I think it's quite funny just because I know Jared gets really mad about it. But like sometimes he like poses for it, and I think it's cute. Like,
Okay. I'm not gonna say a thing. I know who runs it, and it's done in good spirits. It's not meant to be mean. It's not meant to like make fun of him.
After the show, you're gonna let me know.
No,
who that is.
No,
it's classified information.
It's a
the
secret.
Person has sworn us to
it is me. All gun. It is all done in good fun, and it's not meant to hurt him or anything.
How have you not told me?
I found out today.
It's so secret.
Like, by me, how have you not told me?
The fact that you three know it lets me narrow it down to a smaller crew.
Oh, yeah, same.
And I will find out.
By midnight tonight, there'll be a Jackson fan page and a Kyle fan page. Mark my words.
Is it you, Joe?
True.
I love Jared.
I also love Jared.
I will get on that Instagram. I will. By one
okay.
day,
like
they will mistake a picture of me as Jared, and I will be on it.
No, you won't.
Evan.
And also Joe Jonas.
Put that on the Instagram, please. Whoever Jackson is friends with.
All right, moving on to entertainment news. Britney Spears is finally free. On November 12th, a Los Angeles judge ended the conservatorship that controlled the pop singer's life and money for nearly 14 years. Britney has been fighting to get control of her career from her father since 2020, and the case went to court in July of this year. Are you happy to see Britney free from her father's control? If you say no, you can leave. And do you think it should have taken this long for it to happen?
Yeah. I am very happy that she's free because, like, she, like, acted so weird, mm-hmm. like, all that time. Like, she wasn't herself or anything.
Yeah. I think,
and, like, I think it's weird that it was her father. That like
yeah but that's her family's who got all the money from making her do new songs, making her go on tours. They had control over her money. She didn't get to decide, but now she gets to see her kids more. I think they used to be in charge of her medication too, which might have made her act strange. But I would be nowhere without Britney Spears. I love that woman, and the fact that she finally gets to like take control of her own life after like being such an icon, and it's so beautiful. It is such a like nature is healing.
I'm just interested to see what weird things she does next, to be honest.
Yeah, she keeps posting some very sketchy photos on her Instagram. I'm like,
well,
Britney, what are we doing?
Well,
put
I think
some clothes on.
Yeah,
Britney Spears.
I think that's just due to like she's pretty much held captive.
Yeah.
Like for like 14 years, that's bound to drive a person
mentally insane. Like, her mental health has probably gone down the toilet over the past years. And I'm just very glad that she's free, but I hope she regains her sanity soon.
I could get how you could take away, like, custody of kids if someone's crazy, but how can you take away someone's money? It's literally her money. Like, how can you just
it's
take
crazy
away her
that
money?
A conservatorship even is. Exists.
Conservatorship like, is, yeah. Go ahead. He basically, Jamie Spears, her father, was basically, like, when she had, like, her mental breakdown in 2007, I think, he claimed that she wasn't, like, mentally stable enough to take care of herself and became her legal guardian for the next 14 years. And so, like, our parents, I guess, have control over our money. She just never kind of hit that. She never got that experience of, like, being over 18, you know, in her father's eyes. It's messed up stuff.
It's crazy because a conservatorship based on, like, the law is only supposed to last a, like, set number of months. And then they reassess. And then they're set free from that kind of control. They never even, like, reassessed the situation. They just kind of let her stay in this state of having, like, literally no... Like, no, none of that, like, nothing that she was supposed to have. So I'm just, like, confused on why they let her father, who obviously was doing it for the wrong reasons, keep control for so long. Mm-hmm.
Taylor Swift's version of Red was just released on November 12th with new versions of her songs, some featuring collaborations with other artists such as Ed Sheeran and Phoebe Bridgers. Along with her re-released album, she released a 10-minute version of her song All Too Well and a short film as the music video for that song. What are your thoughts on the new versions of her songs? Do you like them better than the originals? Has anyone seen the music video, and what are your thoughts on it?
I love the 10-minute version. It's so personal, and I hate Jake Gyllenhaal.
Yes,
and
yes.
Everything being remade, it's hers now. It's, like, so yes. Nice. Mm-hmm. And, like, that video where she was like, it's mine now, so it's ours now. And Sadie Sink in that video.
So good.
Jake Gyllenhaal is a public enemy. He is a public enemy. I hate that man not so much. Good crap. Actor, not gonna lie, but terrible, terrible man. Taylor Swift.
Have you seen him in Nightcrawler, though?
That's why I said he's a good actor.
Good movie.
Who cares?
The album was average.
Get out.
I saw that album.
I heard everything before. Like, it's nothing new. Like, it's barely anything new.
That's the Taylor Swift.
I find it funny because it's called Red and Ed Sheeran's hair is red. That's the only thing I have about that.
The reason that she re-recorded all of her she's re-recording all of her albums is because I think she doesn't have the rights to her own music anymore. Like, Scooter Braun still.
Yeah, that's why she re-recorded.
Yeah,
it all.
He still gets, like, I guess the money and stuff
money
from her old album. So she kind of, now that she has creative control, is taking over them and actually getting the benefits of having her own music.
Imagine being named Scooter.
I know.
Right? Who's named Scooter? That's something you ride.
That's like something you ride.
Who's named Scooter?
I like the next her topic.
Okay. The new Marvel movie, Eternals, was released November 5th. The movie is about immortal beings with superhuman powers who have lived on the Earth for thousands of years, reuniting to battle evil deviants. With a running time of almost 3 hours, this movie has also two end credits, one featuring Enos, Thanos' brother, played by Harry Styles. Sorry, Enos. One featuring the Black Knight, played by Kit Harington. What do you think about these two characters being newly introduced and reintroduced, brought back into the Marvel Universe, and what do we think about the movie?
It was so good.
I'm about to make everyone else even more mad here. I didn't like it that much.
Joe!
So did Joe. I didn't like it that much either. I didn't like the characters.
Yeah, let's just think here. It was a really good movie.
Yes. It was insane.
And, like, the cinematography and the view, like, all it was so good.
Yes.
It was the visuals.
And then Harry Styles ruined it.
Okay. Oh, you did not disrespect.
The part I didn't like is I could tell there were people in the theater that were only there to see Harry Styles because they didn't know, like, they were just, like, silent the whole time, and then post-credit scene happened and they're like, oh my god, is it gonna be Harry Styles? And then they're like, Harry Styles, and that was it.
So
they
brought it back. It's like a 5-minute clip and you sat through an entire movie.
Exactly, you sat through a 3-hour movie.
And it got leaked before it came out too. Why didn't they just watch it on YouTube?
Yeah, seriously. And now everybody's like a Marvel fan now because of Harry Styles.
Yeah, no.
That's just like when Tom Holland was Spider-Man and then everyone was like, oh, I love Marvel. Tom Holland. And we're like, shut up.
Tom Holland is the worst Spider-Man. That's wrong.
That's no. So, back to Spider-Man.
So, for the actual movie, it like brought up a lot of new like stuff for Marvel and like opened up a lot of new like stuff in their universe. And I thought like, because it was almost 3 hours long, I thought it like introduced and like got you like used to all of those new concepts very well. It yeah. didn't seem like too much. It didn't seem like too slow, too fast. It kind of like just got you into it. Because now that there's, I'm sure they're going to make more Eternals movies.
Me and Jackson went to the movie theater with our mommies. But we had to explain what happened after the movie.
I am going to be angry at Marvel until they find out what to do with Black Panther. Because they need to release a new Black Panther, and they need to find a way to do it.
Okay, well, Joe, there's so much for them to think about with that.
I'm just mad at Marvel, so I'm not going to be able to enjoy one of their movies until that happens.
There's so much. They have to do so much consideration into
also,
that.
Also, Black Knight,
he's gonna be
sick. He's so sick. Like, I'm sure you guys don't know who he is, but he's really cool.
He's
like,
yeah.
get ready.
You should get on
I'm so mad that
who was he trained by? Because the guy that was talking... Like,
oh, no.
In the comics.
Wait, did you see Eternals?
Yeah.
Did you see the post-credits scene?
Yes.
Do you know the voice?
Yes.
At the end, who'd you think it was?
I thought it... Am I allowed to say this?
Just say it.
I forget his name because the guy in the comics trains the Dark Knight, and his name was... Do you know what it is?
Yeah, I know who it is.
Who is it?
It's Blade.
You yeah, know, it's the Blade. Vampire? That's yeah, what his dude. Name is.
Oh
he
my
is
god.
So sick.
Yeah, by Mahershala Ali.
Get him some meds. Blade, who has also not been in the MCU yet, so that's going to open up a whole new movie or TV show.
He kills vampires.
He kills vampires. It's cool. Really cool. No,
what?
I made a joke. I said that's why he's called Blade.
Oh. Okay. Okay. Stranger Things Season 4 is set to come out in the summer of 2022, as stated in the newest trailer. A fourth season was confirmed back in 2019, but production was halted in 2020 due to COVID-19. If you've watched the show before, what do you think the new season will look like? Is this the end of Stranger Things?
It's not the end. They make too much money off of
no,
it.
No, it's almost the end. There's going to be five seasons and... There's going to be five seasons, and not to like burst anybody's bubble or anything, but it has to end with 11 dying.
Yeah, no, that's what I
it
think
makes
that's
sense.
What, that's what they predicted yeah. back when they were creating the show. The Duffer brothers were like, yeah, like she's dying at the end. Yeah.
And then like the season now though, it's exciting because we get to see like where the Mind Flayer like or like thingy like all started.
Yeah.
But I kind of feel like it's going to be bad because nothing can top the third season.
Yeah,
oh
I'm going to be honest.
No, nothing.
I'm going to be honest. I think the show has kind of run its course. Like they can't really... It's a good
They've
show.
Done a lot
I
don't know,
it's
about
a
the
really good
season.
Show. Like the okay. first season is a great show, but it's kind of. I feel like it doesn't really feel like Stranger Things anymore, honestly.
I have two things to say about Stranger Things season 4. One, I'm pretty sure that Finn Wolfhard's contract ends this season, so they might kill off Mike. And also, I think that Hopper is still alive because they
at
the
alive.
End. Yeah, at the end they.
Oh, no, he's in the new trailer.
He's in the new trailer, right?
In the new trailer.
He's bald and in
he's
Russia.
He's just in Russia.
Yeah, because I mean, at the end of even before they released those trailers, I knew because they were like, "Where's the American?" At the end.
Also, mm-hmm.
And they put him in Russia.
In the newest trailer, Millie Bobby Brown looks so much like what's Will's mom's name?
Joyce. Karen.
Joyce. No, like the actual actor.
Winona Ryder.
Oh. Yeah, her.
Ryder.
She looks so much like her, and it just.
I think that's low-key the point.
If yeah. Hopper's alive, don't you guys think Billy will be alive?
No, Billy.
No, Billy
died.
Got
Billy
stabbed.
No,
it was the bad Billy. Thing. There was another Billy.
No, but that
no,
was.
But
it was all.
It's like
him.
The same body.
It was the same
it
body.
It was just like he was.
So
possessed.
Even if his like. Okay. Good Bobby Soul was like still alive. His body
like
was dead.
Also, if they kill off Steve, I'm never
listen
no,
to listen
it's
to Steve's
so
music.
Bad.
Listen to DJ O.
Oh.
His album 2020
Roddy,
is so
yes.
good.
2020. You listen to 2020?
Yeah, it's a good album.
I want it on vinyl so bad, but it's sold out.
Yeah, everything's
it is my
sold
favorite
out.
Album. Calm down. It's really good. Go
calm
give
down,
it a listen.
Calm down.
Jeez, Deborah. No. Okay. This month's unpopular opinion is math is red and English is blue. What do you guys think?
Yes. Math is red.
Math
English is blue. History is yellow. And science is green.
Exactly. Yes.
History is
exactly.
not yellow.
Yes.
No, it's not
English
yellow.
English is yellow.
One at a time, please.
Wait, could you restate that? Like
math is red and
wrong.
English is blue.
Okay, and wrong again.
Oh.
But,
I'm never talking again.
What's your opinion?
But math, green. No. English, purple.
Science is green.
I teach my whole entire homeroom about this one day, and it's a basic. I taught.
Joe, your homeroom consists of three other people.
No, not this one. Like my one at the beginning of the year with like 20 people. I taught them that math is red no matter what. You think of red, you think of math.
Because English, math makes you mad.
English is blue. Yes. No. Some people mix them up, but the one inexcusable thing is to make science anything but green. Yes. Yes. Science has to be green.
No. Yeah, wait, yes, yes.
Science is always
science
green.
Science has to be green. No.
Because grass is green. And also bio is a green liquid.
No. Social studies is green.
No.
It's yellow.
No!
Because of grass!
Okay.
What? You study the land, you study the world. What? Grass.
That's not social studies.
Science is green because frogs.
Science.
Science is blue or purple.
Why? Why? Why?
English is yellow. Yeah.
Why?
Let me just say this real quick. The four core subjects we're talking about are math, English, science, and social studies. And the four colors are red, blue, orange, and yellow can be interchanged. And green. You cannot add another color. Purple does not exist.
Purple is not involved. That is an elective color.
Yeah.
That is an elective color.
Yeah, Spanish.
Yeah, orange isn't a primary color.
I would say orange and
yellow. Neither is green.
Orange and yellow are like interchangeable,
yes,
and
I agree.
So is blue and purple.
No.
God, you guys are so...
I said it on the weather, and I rehashed this conversation, and I will stand by my answer. That's why you talked about it in homeroom. English is blue.
Yep.
No. Math is red.
Yep.
Science, is green.
And yes.
History is yellow. Spanish
yes.
is purple.
Okay,
ready?
If you so choose. You got the last two right. Spanish is very purple.
Spanish is so purple.
History is very yellow. And if you have a secondary math class, it's orange because your main math class is red.
You're
and English
wrong.
Is blue.
You're just wrong.
Can we all agree that math is red?
Yes.
No.
Why
no.
do you think it's not red? Why
it's,
do you think it's not red?
It's blue.
Why
first
do you think
off,
it's blue?
Because no. math is cold.
His
and blue
math
is cold. Yes.
Okay, so math for me was always green.
No.
I don't know why.
I think we all disagree.
I don't care. That's an unpopular opinion. science would be a mixture, either green or purple. I don't know why. Social studies is always yellow, no matter what. It's no other color. Maybe red, but no other color other than that. And like English, I don't really care about English colors. Like it could be any color you want.
Evan,
so.
You look like you're ready.
Yeah. All right. So math is red because math makes me angry.
Okay.
All right.
Love.
Spanish is yellow because Spanish speaking countries are very sunny and the sun is yellow and the sun is yellow. Okay. All the other ones I don't care about, but science is usually blue.
Yeah. Science
okay.
is blue.
Okay. I can see science is blue.
No.
When you think English, you think poems. When you think poems, you think stuff that makes you sad, depression.
Blue.
Unfortunately.
Yeah. That's why English is blue.
Unfortunately, we must end the discussion for this month. That is all for the November episode of Insight. Thank you for tuning in. See you then. See you then. Oh, no.